Hi students, this is Dr. Badrinath and today's topic is National Urban. Urban means city. Okay, National Urban Health Mission. Okay, and I feel that it is important. Definitely it will be a question in your examination. See here, Mahila Arogya Samiti, MAS, M-A-S, MAS. Mahila Arogya Samiti is an important part of the National Urban Health Mission. See the points very carefully. National Urban Health Mission, also called as a NU Urban, N-U-H-M. That point you have to keep in your mind. I will come back to this MAS, Mahila Arogya Samiti. Okay, right. We are studying a subject of social and preventive pharmacy, also called as social and preventive medicine. Right? It is important for all medical, including MBBS also, all medical and paramedical staff. Right? Students, including lab technician, nursing. Okay? See the topic here, the chapter number 5. We are in the last chapter and we have completed all the subject. All the videos are available in my channel playlist. Total syllabus is there in my channel playlist. You just click on the playlist. There you can be fine. Here the highlighted point, National Urban Health Mission, keep in your mind. Okay? See, in the last video, I have already completed rural sanitization. It's nothing but rural development. It was completed. Rural means villages. Urban means cities. Okay, this rural part I have already completed. It was available in my channel, same subject playlist. Right? And points what I have covered here is the NUHM, Urban, U, Urban, wherever. Introduction, what is this program? What are the goals, activities, aims, objectives, almost all same. Okay? And UPHC, Primary Health Center, it was, I saw a video, I made already video, I think you saw already. Here, PHC, U is there. Urban Primary Health Center is there. Urban Community Health Center is also there. Okay? And MAS, main important point here is the MAS. So we will cover all these UPHC, UCHC, and the MAS. In the MAS, we will cover the formation of the MAS, how the MAS will be formed and what are the members and the activities and functions of the MAS. Very, very important for examination. Mahila Arogya Samiti is the key point here in this videos. Okay, right. See, first one, here you can see our topic. National Urban Health Mission, NUHM. Okay, National Urban Health Mission. Here you can see here, National Urban Health Mission. Then what it is, this is a rural. This is the cities. Okay, here you can see the rural, National Rural Health Mission. Okay, right. See, all these villages, cities. This is a cities development program. This is a village development program. Here you can see the logo also, National Rural Health Mission. Here you can see the National Urban Health Mission. See the logo, small difference is there. But both are comes under National Health Mission. This is commonly called as a NHM. This is a NRHM. This is a NUHM. In the examination, don't get confusion. Sometimes they'll give you the short NUHM they will give. So you might confusion and you are writing a rural. Okay, not like that. Okay, very clear picture. All these two are comes under the National Health Mission, right? Okay. And if you see the introduction, national, the same point, National Health Mission is divided into NUHM, NRHM. NUHM is a part of NHM. It was launched in the 2013 and it was directed by the director and it is monitored by the central government appointed people or appointed staff. Okay, and main vision is the strengthening of the urban region. That is the main vision of this program, and it focuses mainly on the reproductive problems, maternal, mother problems. It actually it focuses on all, each and every program only. Urban development means total development, health development in the urban region, but mainly focuses on the reproductive. After reproduction, maternal. Maternal from neonatal. All the links, see the links so that easily you can keep in. And child's and adolescent. Child will become an adolescent like that. So if all these stages are developed automatically, entire health will be automatically, it will be corrected. And it focuses on the areas of communicable and also non-communicable diseases also. Both, okay, communicable, non-communicable. And also focuses on the areas of reproductive, the tunnel, maternal, neonatal, and all. And here you can see the areas, north, east. This is the east, this is the north. Here you can see the north, Jammu and Kashmir. government is giving a more funds under this scheme to these states because they are the lack of not see is always South India is already developed. Here you can see the South India. This is the North India. So South India is already developed well when compared to the North India. Okay, that point you have to. This is the East, Bay of Bengal. East is there here. So NUHM giving a more preference to the northeastern states like this, like Jammu, Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, etc. You can write Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, everything and all. And it is a part of 12th five-year plan. We have already known that India is following the five-year plans. It is very, very important bit for in general studies. For pharmacists also, it is important for RRB and all. Nation is providing a following the five-year plans. Every 5 year, one plan will be there. So it is a 12th five-year plan. Okay. Budget allotment is 30,000 crores. Just imagine for the cities, how much the government is giving. And state government has to be involved. See here, both state government and central government has to share the funds in the ratio of 75 to 25. It is not only the government, 30,000 crores total budget, in that 75% will be there to the central government and 25% will be there. And here, what are the main goals or aims or objectives, whatever it may be, reduction of the IMR. IMR means infant mortality rate, death rate. Infants are started dying. It was more nearly 50, 60, 70 was there out of 1,000. Out of 1,000 births, 1,000 deliveries, 80, 90 or 100 also sometimes it crossed. That they have to bring back, bring down. That they have to bring down to the 30. So this is called an infant mortality rate. And maternal mortality ratio. Previously it was high, but they want to reduce it to the only one person can die out of 1,000. Okay, it is a reasonable only like that. They thought here 30 and here 1. Say they didn't made it 0 because 0 is a problem because it is different people having a different health. And universal access to the reproductive, I already told, reproductive, maternal, childs. These are the very important adolescents. And convergence of all health related inventions and malaria and communicable, non-communicable diseases, I have told you. Here it comes, malaria reduction by 50%. Kala Azar, it is also one of the important diseases, reduced to 0. Kala Azar, 0. And filariasis reduction to 20%. Filariasis by using a diethyl carbamazepine, very, very important that they can be made up to 0. They will from 100% to 20%, they have to bring it. And dengue mortality reduction, 50%. And dengue, they have to reduce half of the dengue. Okay. And chikungunya control of chikungunya and TB through the DOTS program. I have already explained what is a DOTS program in the TB video. Okay, National Tuberculosis Control Program. I have already explained. They have to reduce the cases of TB to the 15%. Yeah, this is a very, very important and public health facilities which are under the NUHM. Various levels are there. See here, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. Four levels are there under the NUHM, National Urban Health Mission. What are these four levels? See, first one is medical officer in charge of the UPHC. I have already told you, Urban Primary Health Center. So around for level of 50,000 population, one UPHC will be there. Very, 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 very important structure. This structure is very, very important. So first level, this facilitates supports to the ANM. ANM, see, medical officer UPHC has to support the ANM. What is ANM? ANM, auxiliary nurse midwife. Midwife, not housewife. Okay, not housewife. Okay. Facilitative support to the ASHA, ANM. Every 10,000 population, one ANM will be there. They have to facilitate the ASHA. See here, UPHC is facilitating the ANM. ANM is facilitating the ASHA. ASHA is facilitating the MAS. This is the clear-cut structure. And MAS, you can see, mobilization, that Mahila Arogya Samiti, that in the introduction, so first slide, I have kept this one only. ASHA means accredited social health activists. And this is 200 to 500 slum holders. One ASHA worker will be there. Under that, 50 to 100 slum holders, one MAS will be there. So MAS is the basic functional unit and structural unit of the NUHM. That point you have to keep in your mind. Number of MAS together, it forms ASHA. ASHA, number of ASHAs comes, forms ANM. ANM, number of ANMs comes together, then it forms a UPHC. Okay, that points are very, very important. And slum holders like this, each houses like a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 near to like that, each houses. So 50 to 100 slum holders, okay, around 20 houses or 30 houses, one mass will be there. Mahila Arogya Samiti, these four levels are hierarchy. You have to write in the exam in the hierarchy wise, right? And first one is UPHC, first level. UPHC, Urban Primary Health Center, 50,000 to 60,000, I have already told you here, 50,000 population, 50,000 to 60 population located preferably within a slum area or near the slum area. That is very, very important. Half kilometer radius only, within a half kilometer radius, that much of population must be there. 25,000 to 30,000 with the provisions of evening of the OPD. This is very, very important point. It's mainly focusing on the OPD, outpatient department. Whereas the next one coming second level, IPD, inpatient department. That's why I told you here OPD 50 to 60,000, UPHC. Okay, here what are the available services here? OPD services, outpatient. Here who are all there? Here one medical officer in charge, one part-time medical officer, three staff nurses, one pharmacist, one lab technician, one all these are the staffs of the UPHC. Basic diagnostic services, referral services, collection and reporting of the vital and counseling and communicable, non-communicable services also they are providing. This is about a UPHC first level. Second level is the CHC. Urban, this is also first level only. UPHC or urban CHC. See, keep in your mind. This urban CHC mainly focusing on the inpatient, IPD. That's why here, see here, beds will come. There it not came. Beds will come here, 30 to 50 beds. So it is a inpatient department. Number of doctors also more here. See here, 5 to 6 doctors. There it is not like that. One doctor is one medical officer will be there. This is about CHC, UCHC, UPHC, both comes under primary level only. And the last level, and ASHA worker, that and all separate videos are available, are not much important. ANM and ASHA workers. Last one is mass is very, very important because it is a basic structural unit of the entire program and process of the mass formation, how they will form. Step one, constitution of a team. First one, they will constitute the team. Okay, you like that all together. First one, they constitute. Next, meetings. Meetings. First one is constitution. Second one is meetings. They will discuss and they will identify. Third step, they will identify who is active. See here. Active and committed women who are all very active and very committed women only. And that is identification. And fourth one is formation of a mass selection of official bearers like a secretary or president among the mass. Okay, these are the mass members. Here you can see members of local CBO. CBO means here I have mentioned community-based organization. And ICDS frontline staff. ICDS means Integrated Child Development Service Scheme. And existing SH, self-help groups. Here you can see self-help group. Service users, local women, ASHA, opinion of leaders, like that. Okay, this is the members. Just list is enough. And we came to the last. 8 functions are there. Here I have shown 4. In the next last slide, I will show you 4. So here, what they will do, always they have to support the supporting organization of a urban health and nutrition and day. Mobilizing the pregnant, on that day, they have to mobilize the women and the children, particularly to the marginalized families. Margin, where very economically very marginalized. And they have to support the ANM and support the AWW, Anganwadi workers here. Okay. And ASHA workers, I have already explained, accredited help. Okay, and UHND, Urban Health Nutritional Day. Like that, here mobilizing the pregnant women, here coordination, here supporting, see here supporting, here coordinating ASHA and ANM, here supporting ASHA, aid, Anganwadi workers, okay, allowing the community services provider activating the mass. So these 4, you can take a screenshot and these are the 4 totally. So total 8 are there. All these 8 are very, very important. Okay. And providing immediate information on any maternal child headed to the ASHA, ANM or UPHC medical officer, they have to inform. In any case, information is very, very important. Immediate information they have to give in case of any maternal or child death. In case of that, immediately make a phone call or take a cell phone or immediately you have to inform. That is providing important amenities missing in the Anganwadi centers. That is the mass job. See, Anganwadi centers, they have to go and visit the Anganwadi center. If any devices are left or any devices, instruments or amenities, facilities, if it is left, they have to make them proper arrangement, providing immediate information and any disease outbreak. During the disease outbreak, like a corona, girona and all, if it is there, if you find immediate, it is a communicable disease. If you got doubt, immediately you have to inform. Like that, all these 8 points you have to write in the examination. Okay, right. Keep watching my playlist. I kept in all subject wise.